Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new Ninjago video here on the channel. My name is TannerFishies. In today's video, we are going to be discussing Ninjago Dragons Rising Season 2 Episode 1, entitled The Blood Moon, and more specifically, Lloyd's vision. What exactly that was all about, because there are many, many things in this vision that are either confusing, shocking, or both, and I want to spend some time breaking down the actual scene itself and talking about everything that there is to see inside this scene, and of course, speculating for the future. With that being said, this video will contain spoilers for Ninjago Dragons Rising Season 2. You have been warned, and without further ado, let's talk about the scene in question. Alright, so just going to the actual scene here, I want to talk about this vision right here first and foremost. The first vision that Lloyd has, or I guess the first full vision that he has in Dragons Rising Season 2. This whole sequence in Episode 1, a lot of this does actually foreshadow events that we will see in Dragons Rising Season 2 Episode 2, Shattered Dreams. For example, the wolf masks being here and showing up. We also have a couple of sequences later on involving some specific ninja that we will talk about, but some stuff in this vision is definitely for later events, such as this sequence right here, where we see a glimpse at Beatrix. Now, Beatrix being in this vision is definitely important in some way, and we do see more of her later on in the season in other visions, and also later on in this vision as well, so stay tuned. But Beatrix being here, again, if these visions are, I guess, important for the future of Dragons Rising in terms of a series, and also in terms of the ninja themselves, and Lloyd, and all that, then Beatrix will eventually return. In what capacity, we have yet to see, but eventually Beatrix will be coming back. If this vision is anything to go off of, like, why would she be in the vision if she isn't going to be returning, right? Surely she will have some type of relevance down the line. Even if she's not coming back physically, she will have some type of relevance to Dragons Rising itself. And again, more on Beatrix here in a second, but as we can see, we do have Zane fighting off some wolf mask shadow guys here. This is one of the sequences that is important for Episode 2, so this more or less foreshadows the ninja fighting the wolf mask shadow army guys in the Cloud Kingdom. Again, we see that go down in Episode 2. So nothing really to note here. We keep on flashing to this symbol, which I do think means something. Now, this symbol is associated with the Source Dragon of Motion. That is indeed the Motion symbol, one of the seven Source Dragons, but why does it continuously show up in Lloyd's visions? We can see later in the season as well, this vision pops up a lot too, which means that this Source Dragon in particular will have at least something to do, some type of major role down the line. Now, there are a couple of set rumors really quick that I just want to quickly talk about surrounding an upcoming Ninjago set known as the Source Dragon of Motion or Source Dragon of Fire, depending on where you get your information. And that, of course, is this set right here, set number 71822, Dragon of the Traffic Sources, according to this mistranslated Polish website. But this website is accurate for the majority of the time, so keep that in mind. But this set is being described as the largest dragon in the series, with a movable head, neck, tail, legs, large wings. On its back, there is a throne-shaped saddle and gong. So, yeah, saddle and gong. The gong in particular, also I guess the throne-shaped saddle, kind of makes me feel like this will be some type of Lord Wrath's dragon, right? The gong of shattering could be literally attached to the back of the dragon. There is a throne-shaped saddle. Who else would try to get a throne on their dragon if not someone like Lord Wrath? Someone who's villainous, you know what I'm saying? So, the dragon of the traffic sources, or again, the Source Dragon of Motion, Source Dragon of Fire, the one that's associated with that motion symbol, could very well turn out to be villainous. We have this evidence right here coming at us from the set information, and we have all of the stuff in Lloyd's vision featuring the motion symbol itself. So I'd keep an eye on this motion source dragon. Maybe they are not all that they claim to be. Maybe this dragon actually is evil in some way. Maybe this is the true master of Lord Wrath, right? I will say as well, the symbol also does look kind of evil-esque, I suppose. Looks more like fire than anything, but I guess it looks kind of evil. Moving on from that, we have this vision right here, this sequence where Sora is, you know, not really doing so well. She gets covered up by a bunch of stones that fall from the sky on top of her. Now, what could this mean in relation to Lloyd? Well, you know, Lloyd does have his fear of the younger members of the team getting injured, so maybe something will happen to Sora at some point down the line where she gets covered up by rocks or something similar. She gets injured in some way. I imagine Lloyd would blame himself for that, since he was not there to protect Sora, clearly, and I'm sure that would also not go over very well with somebody like Aaron, who we do see later in this vision as well. More on him in a bit. But first, going back to Empress Beatrix here. Beatrix herself is back again in the vision, making a second appearance. Hello, Beatrix. And she actually has something interesting going on. She has this sword here. And considering that they make a pretty big deal showcasing this sword, what exactly is this sword? What exactly does it do? It has some type of purple gem in the middle, but it's not exactly clear what this sword does outside of that. It could be made of some type of special material. It does kind of look like the crystallized weapons that we saw in the crystallized sets, but I'm not sure what relation that would have in terms of the show. But what exactly does this sword do? That is a fantastic question that this vision obviously does not answer. But we do see the sword shatter on the ground. So whatever the sword is, it is something important, something that is crucial to the plot of Dragon's Rising in some way. But in terms of what it does, we have yet to see. It also does kind of look like a dragon, perhaps, so maybe it has some type of relevance to the Source Dragons. Maybe it's an ancient Source Dragon weapon of some kind. Again, who's really to say, but I imagine this would make for a very interesting plot point moving forward. And rounding out the vision, we have a couple of other notable scenes in this vision. First of all, Aaron running at the camera. Now, I've mentioned this in a video before, but if you consider the camera being Lloyd's perspective and Aaron literally runs up and punches the camera, this could very well be Aaron punching Lloyd. Now, this could be for a number of reasons. Again, we saw in Dragon's Rising Season 2, Aaron is kind of going through a little bit of a tough spot here. He feels weak. He feels useless. Lord Rass even kind of tells him that he is. So maybe this is Aaron finally rebelling against Lloyd, telling him that, you know, you're not doing anything for my training, you're not making me any better, so he just freaks out and punches Lloyd. Or going back to the Sora vision where she gets covered up by rocks, maybe this is Aaron responding to that. Maybe he's mad that Lloyd could not protect her. Maybe something goes seriously wrong, Sora gets seriously injured, and Aaron loses it. Either way, you could see this as Aaron rebelling against Lloyd in some way, punching Lloyd in the face. Drama. Yes, indeed. Drama City. I'm very curious to see what this is all about. And finally, we have a final little sequence here. Nothing really too concerning for the future of Dragon's Rising, but this is Egalt in front of the Blood Moon. And we've seen this before. Now, I guess you could see this as being somewhat concerning because Egalt does attack Lloyd here, it seems. But again, we saw this in Season 2. Part 1 already with the ninja training. Egalt literally breathed this blue fire ice thing at the ninja already, so you could see this as maybe Egalt, again, betraying them in the future, or you could just see this as a sign for Dragon's Rising Season 2 Part 1. I'm more inclined to believe that. I love how terrified Lloyd looks as he just gets blasted in the face with this. But overall, guys, that'll pretty much do it for my quick thoughts on Lloyd's vision that he has in Episode 1. He freaks out and does Spinjitzu against the wall. Very intriguing vision with a lot of breadcrumbs laid down for the future of Dragon's Rising, not only in terms of Part 1 stuff that we've already seen, but obviously other future stuff that we have not seen play out, like Beatrix coming back, all of the stuff with Sora and Aaron. Very curious to see what all of this means. In the meantime, feel free to leave all of your thoughts down below in the comments surrounding what you think about this entire sequence. What do you think these visions mean? What do you think the future of Dragon's Rising has in store, if anything? And what do you think this sword does in particular? That I'm especially curious to see. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. That'll wrap it up for my thoughts here. If you guys enjoyed this one, feel free to like and subscribe, do all that fun stuff, and I will talk to you guys again very, very soon. Peace.